Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chansom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Tuesday, the 29th of September. Indian Prime Minister Modi hits out at opposition over farm law protests. Pakistan's opposition PMLN breathes defiance after Shehbaz Sharif's arrest. An Afghan official Abdullah meets Pakistani leadership to discuss peace bid. And now for all the details. In the wake of protests by farmers and various opposition parties against three new agriculture-related laws, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Tuesday hit out at the opposition saying those opposing farm laws are insulting farmers.
Hitting out at the opposition parties, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Tuesday said some people are opposing the recently legalized farm reform bills as yet another source of earning black money has been closed for them. His remarks came a day after a group of workers from opposition Congress Party's youth wing set a tractor on fire in capital New Delhi during protest against the controversial farm laws. Prime Minister Modi said that those burning farm equipment to show their anger were insulting farmers while inaugurating six mega projects in northern Uttarakhand state under the Namami Gange mission through a video conference.
अब देश का किसान कहीं पर भी किसी को भी अपनी उपज बेच सकता है, लेकिन आज जब केंद्र सरकार किसानों को उनके अधिकार दे रही है तो भी ये लोग विरोध पर उतर आए हैं। ये लोग चाहते हैं कि देश का किसान खुले बाजार में अपनी उपज नहीं बेच पाए।
मीनवाइल मेंबर्स ऑफ किसान मजदूर संघर्ष कमेटी वोर ब्लैक क्लोथ्स एज देयर रेलवे ब्लॉकेड एजिटेशन ऑन रेलवे ट्रैक्स इन अमृतसर सिटी अगेंस्ट फार्म लॉज एंटर द सिक्स्थ डे ऑन ट्यूसडे. In wake of widespread agitations in several states, the government has asserted that the new laws will free farmers from the clutches of middlemen and allow them to sell their produce anywhere they want at a remunerative price.
In news from Pakistan, Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz has said the arrest of party's president Shehbaz Sharif on corruption charges is a political move and linked to planned nationwide protests by the opposition parties against Prime Minister Imran Khan-led government. The party said the drive against the fascist regime had begun.
As the National Accountability Bureau on Monday arrested Shehbaz Sharif, the president of Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz or PMLN party, and the parliamentary leader of opposition on corruption charges, his party said the drive against the fascist regime had begun. Shehbaz Sharif was arrested outside the Lahore High Court after his bail plea was rejected in a money laundering case for assets beyond means. His PMLN party blamed it is a move linked to planned nationwide protests by the opposition calling for Prime Minister Imran Khan to step down. PMLN leader Maryam Nawaz said, "If there's any semblance of justice in Pakistan, then instead of her uncle Shehbaz Sharif, Imran Khan's aide Lieutenant General Asim Bajwa, the chairman of the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor Authority, should have been arrested over alleged concealment of offshore business assets.
Agar koi kanoon hai, koi insaaf hai, ya koi semblance of kanoon ya insaaf hai, to phir giriftari Shehbaz Sharif ki nahi honi chahiye thi. फिर गिरफ्तारी जनरल आसिम सलीम बाजवा की होनी चाहिए थी, क्योंकि शहबाज शरीफ के नाम ये 99 कंपनीज नहीं निकली, शहबाज शरीफ के नाम वो सैकड़ों फ्रेंचाइज नहीं निकले.
नाइन मेजर ओपोजिशन पार्टीज लास्ट वीक डिनाउंस द मिलिट्री फॉर मेडलिंग इन पॉलिटिक्स and rigging the 2018 elections to bring Imran Khan to power. Opposition parties have long blamed the anti-graft agency is used by the military for selected accountability, as it does not touch powerful generals or Imran Khan's ministers.
Moving on, a massive protest was held in Gilgit-Baltistan to demand immediate release of political prisoners detained by Pakistani state and its army. The protesters blamed draconian anti-terrorism acts are misused by Islamabad to crush any civil dissent in the illegally occupied region.
A massive protest was held by locals and activists in Gilgit-Baltistan's Skartu recently to demand immediate release of political prisoners detained by Pakistani state and its army. The protesters also highlighted the case of activist Baba Jan, who has been languishing in jail for more than 6 years now for leading a mass movement seeking compensation for survivors of a landslide which killed several and rendered hundreds homeless. They blamed the Draconian Schedule 4 and Anti-Terrorism Act are misused against activists and have been framed on purpose to crush any civil dissent in the illegally occupied region.
कोई दहशतगर्द नहीं थे. आज हमारे ये दोस्त कोई असलहा लेकर जद्दोजहद करने वाले लोग नहीं थे. ये हमारी तरह जमहूरी प्रोसेस के थ्रू अपने राइट्स लेना चाहते थे.
Activists have long accused the Pakistan government of systematically launching crackdowns on the people who try to educate and aware public about the nefarious designs of Islamabad.
Chairman of Afghan High Council for National Reconciliation Abdullah Abdullah on Monday met top Pakistani leadership including Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi in Islamabad to discuss the Afghan peace process. Abdullah is on a 3-day official visit to the country, seen as vital to the success of peace talks with Taliban.
Chairman of Afghanistan's High Council for National Reconciliation, Abdullah Abdullah, on Monday met top Pakistani leadership in capital Islamabad as he began his 3-day official visit to the country, seen as vital to the success of peace talks with Taliban. Abdullah was greeted by Pakistan's Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi as he arrived at the Foreign Office, where the two sides held talks. Pakistan's foreign ministry informed that Qureshi during the meeting reaffirmed Pakistan's steadfast support for the peace process and emphasized there is no military solution to the Afghan conflict while encouraging all parties to reach a political solution. Abdullah also met Asad Qaisar, Speaker of Pakistan's National Assembly, on Monday and discussed issues of bilateral interest. Relations between Pakistan and Afghanistan have long been rocky. Afghanistan and its international allies have for years accused Pakistan of backing the Taliban insurgent group as a way to limit the influence of old rival India in Afghanistan.
In news from Sri Lanka, the chief magistrate of a court in Sri Lankan capital Colombo on Monday imposed travel ban on Stereo Elias, the captain of the stricken New Diamond super tanker which caught fire with a cargo of 2 million barrels of oil last month. He has been detained in Sri Lanka as he goes through legal proceedings.
Stereos Elias, the captain of the stricken New Diamond super tanker which caught fire with a cargo of 2 million barrels of oil, appeared in a court in Sri Lankan capital Colombo on Monday. He has been detained in Sri Lanka as he goes through legal proceedings. The Chief Magistrate Court in Colombo on Monday imposed a travel ban on Elias, a Greek national, who may face charges of negligence and pollution. The ban is effective until the next court hearing. The Attorney General's department previously told the court that the captain failed to activate the onboard fire suppression system and inform relevant authorities when the fire broke out on the supertanker on 3rd of September. The owners of the New Diamond have agreed to pay $2.27 million to Sri Lanka for its help in extinguishing the blaze and averting disaster. The claim is for services provided by the Sri Lankan Navy, Air Force, Port Authorities and Marine Environment Protection Authority or MEPA. The new diamond, loaded with Kuwaiti oil, is chartered by Indian Oil Corporation and is currently on Sri Lanka's east coast.
Moving on to news from Nepal. The prices of onions has skyrocketed in Nepal after India halted its export this month after heavy rains damaged the crop. Amid rising prices of onions in the retail market in Nepal, residents in capital Kathmandu are flocking state-owned trading entity to buy onions at reduced prices. Amid rising prices of onions in the retail market in Nepal, residents of capital Kathmandu on Monday flocked the state-owned trading entity Food Management and Trading Company or FMTC to buy onions for 60 Nepali rupees per kilogram. The price of onions has skyrocketed after India halted its export this month, that now stands at least 120 Nepali rupees in the local market per kilogram. FMTC is selling the onions that were seized from the black marketers inside various locations of Kathmandu about 2 weeks ago. Nepal always has been importing onions from India, as its own production is not enough to meet the domestic demands. Though Chinese onions are in the Nepali market, the consumers prefer the Indian variety. India on September 14 prohibited the export of all varieties of onion after its crop was damaged and harvesting delayed by excessive rain. Authorities in India's Jammu and Kashmir organized various activities including water sports and famous Shikara race in the iconic Dal Lake to mark the World Tourism Day this past weekend. They even aim to kickstart tourism activities which have been badly affected due to the coronavirus pandemic.
A number of water sport activities were organized in Srinagar city of India's Jammu and Kashmir on Sunday on the occasion of World Tourism Day to give a boost to the tourism sector in the Union Territory. Activities like racing of famous Shikara boats, canoe racing and kayaking saw enthusiastic participants race in the iconic Dal Lake.
Aaj ke mauke par yahi actually hamara jo maqsad hai ye karne ka ki hum logon ko message dena chahte hain bahar ke logon ko ki aap log aaiye yahan pe Kashmir Jammu Kashmir aaiye hum welcome kar rahe hain koi pareshani nahi hai yahan pe ha covid ki wajah se jo thoda problem ho gayi thi jo tourist ghumna chahte hain wo nahi ghum sakte hain. लेकिन अब कोई परेशानी नहीं है
बहुत बूस्ट मिला कि क्योंकि आज बहुत एक्टिविटीज़ हो रही है कायाकिंग हो रहा है कैनान हो रही है साइकिलिंग हो रही है और रनिंग हो रही है तो मैंने भी आज 15 किलोमीटर रन की अराउंड द डाल तो इससे बहुत बूस्ट मिलेगा टूरिज्म डिपार्टमेंट को.
India's Kashmir Valley is known as a popular tourist spot across the world for its unique Shikara boats and houseboat stays along with its Himalayan beauty. However, the coronavirus pandemic has restricted people to their homes and most of them are avoiding traveling due to the fear of contracting the disease. This has brought huge losses to Kashmir's tourism industry.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter at @asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.